Hey there, welcome to Life Noggin. Our solar system is pretty weird. Over the past few decades, scientists have discovered and confirmed over 1,000 exoplanets, which are planets that orbit other stars. And those star systems have quite a few differences from this one. See, most solar systems have their larger planets orbit their host stars closer than Mercury orbits the Sun. In fact, in 1995, the exoplanet 51 Pegasi b was discovered, which has half the mass of Jupiter, but is 20 times closer to its star than Earth is to the Sun. These types of exoplanets, which are creatively called hot Jupiters, are quite common in other solar systems, but weirdly, they are missing from ours. Coincidentally, hot Jupiter was also my college nickname. Haha. That's a story for another time. So why are our largest planets so far away from the Sun? Well, to be honest, scientists aren't quite sure, those good old scientists, but that hasn't stopped them from coming up with hypotheses. And this is where the wandering Jupiter idea comes in. Some scientists believe that when our solar system was a little youngin', the Sun was potentially surrounded by super Earth rocky planets. But then our good friend Jupiter moved inward, whose gravitational pull changed the orbits of these planets, causing them to collide with one another and, you know, smash them into pieces. Some of which were hurtled into the Sun. What a way to go. However, as Jupiter later retreated, being pulled away from the Sun by the formation of Saturn, any leftover debris eventually formed into the rocky planets we know today: Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars. And this does a good job of explaining why the inner planets are younger than the outer gas giants. So essentially, if this is actually what happened, if it weren't for Jupiter, life on Earth would not exist. Now, that's not saying that life wouldn't be possible at all, but Earth may not have ever formed if Jupiter hadn't come in and destroyed what was there before. And not only is Jupiter potentially responsible for allowing Earth to form in the first place, but it also helps protect you now. See, in the last decade alone, Jupiter has been hit by at least 5 comets or asteroids. In fact, recent images from March 17, 2016 show that Jupiter was hit by a small object. And these impacts are just the ones that we've seen. Some scientists predict that these collisions probably happen 1 to 5 times every month. And if it wasn't for Jupiter's huge gravitational force deflecting these objects away from Earth, you humans may have been struck by them instead. And honestly, as your friend, I don't recommend that at all. But there's also a theory that Jupiter might steer space rocks our way, possibly causing impact events. Man, Jupiter, I just don't know anymore. But we should still all be grateful that Jupiter exists. I mean, if it didn't, you probably wouldn't be here watching this video. And that'd be pretty sad, you know? On the topic of hypothetical questions, what if the Earth doubled in size? Check out this video.
How would that change things? Well, first off, gravity would be very different. The Earth would have 8 times as much mass, and gravity would be twice as strong.
There's a link in the description if you're on mobile. Make sure you come back every Monday for a brand new video. As always, I'm Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.